by Matt Walker, finishing second on the podium yesterday in Pro Am. It is M3 Power T30 on Wood and Tires. He's out to put a set of West Links on today and see how he gets on in the protest. Nice fast entry as we were used to seeing all throughout yesterday.
Yeah, Matt Walker doing an absolutely sterling job yesterday, and he looked absolutely perfect in practice as he stuck it on the door of some of these pro guys and proved that he's got the work to be in this pro class. And this day, again, another driver looking like he's absolutely benefited from all those runs yesterday as he nailed it across the line.
Running out of steam a little bit more on the finish line.
Oh, you know, the West Lakes just make it.
Yeah. This old car has been It is of course the supercharged VA of Shane Lynch, Boyzone band member, and all out nice guy.
Yeah.
And he is here in his character, working on new tires this weekend from Axis Tires, and this car representing Jasmine. And of course looks incredible, and it looks like it's going incredible too out there, Ian, as he is taking this track by the throat a little bit.
Yeah, he's got it around the neck, he's definitely pulling it together and trying to get it right there. Could have been a little bit tidier, a little bit higher up on the back.
As I'm concerned, he had the one that makes it. marshals pumping his fist knew it was a good run. If there was a man though that tried to top qualifying, it might just be
Top qualifier, Matt
Carter, going for that spot. As he pushes as well, there's one of me, angle all the way across the line from Matt Carter. Can he go top 8? Drop a lot of red in the
Good three, and again another big pull up there for Matt Carter. Look at this, he's been moving.
to the door. So Adam Simmons, after he had his car, makes another dive for a 7.1. This is textbook base driving by Matt Carr. Team side, give it up for Matt Carr and Adam Simmons. Wow. Simmons, you've got what the judges are for. Now Hayden, known for his textbook chase driving, can he get closer?
Absolutely brilliant driving there from Hayden. Fantastic stuff. He did everything he could in as far as I can see.
So Wes Keane is going to his second off his belt next. He knows that PA is very consistent. He's got a very good line round. So a lot of confidence on Wes Keane's side as he fires that car in, but fails to initiate. Big clutch kick after Canoe Point 1. PA has a perfect qualifying line again. Wes Keane got good proximity. Look at this from Wes Keane. Now starts to get nice and close on Hayden, as Hayden, like you say, technical and very, very straight. Oh, Wes Keane balancing that car on the edge of straight in and drifting.
You know what? So we almost ripped up behind here, and we did a good job of getting it here.
Wow, what a battle. Yeah, exactly. Would you like to have seen them both in the top 16 and see what damage they can
do? If you're a fan of incredibly long cars,
here's this is your time.
This is your time. It is the last sale for of Wayne Keeper to lead in Louis Lawrence. Louis Lawrence, a pro-am driver, going to make a name for himself here today. But Wayne Keeper said he's coming to rewrite the roles of Brown. And look at that line from Keeper. Look at Lawrence, though. He's right there on a big dive into the first pass. So straight a little bit on the wrong angle. Trying to avoid contact. Look at this. Keeper slowed a little dramatically there at the climb of the corner. And Louis Lawrence is still there, but almost falling off the track as well. As he's going in this run, but massive aggression from over these guys.
Yeah, absolutely.
Simon Perry in the big GT1 is going to give it a go. He's going for a big man's entry.
Out here, it was very hard to see. Did I get nice and close and they come around? I'm back in formation.
yesterday. She was a female drift car driver who came into this event looking for a spot in front of qualifying, but unfortunately the car broke and she couldn't make it.
The rest of the guys back into the final lanes to come back in formation to the last corner. Look at this!
Look at Danny Grundy, tagged on the back bumper, Richard over this car. Oh, only a run there for those guys. Seaside, give it up for Team LDR.
Formation, only seems to get into the bit now. Here we go, that's my motor course stop, and it's all wild. We go through the chicane, and there are three, they're all in formation here. Let's see what happens.
Look at this, I'm saying slide.
All in formation.
Yeah.
Where's Keating? Has just disappeared and shut it down. Where's Keating? Shut it down as they come around the last corner. And what? I'm not too sure what happened there. First run. Now, it looks like it's going to be Matt Carter to lead him in. This is it, Matt Carter's chance here. 10 seconds.
Look at the entry from Grimmers. He fires that car in, but a little bit of separation coming to the bank. As Carter again drops back up for a lot there. Clipping point number three. And separation. Jumps on the door as they come across the line. Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Matt Carter and Richard Grimmers.
Danny Grundy, though, as he pushed the right to the edge of the circuit, just barely almost staying on. Hurry now, trying to force the issue. didn't get that exclamation point going right to the back bumper of Danny Grundy as they come around the last corner. Perry is right there. Wow, nice finish in a
perfect. So just a little bit scrappy, but great proximity the whole way, so a good advantage for Oliver Evans, 7-3-1-6.
So an advantage to Oliver Evans. Shanahan bumping the back of Evans' car on the start line. Shanahan says it's not happening again, but after that chase, what does Jack Shanahan have to do here to take this victory and go to the final four? He has to be perfect. He has to be on the door, and Evans has to nail that qualifying line. This could be a rivalry for the ages right now, because neither of these guys are afraid of each other one bit. It is Evans to lead Shanahan in the chase, and we know Shanahan has to pull in one of the runs of his career to go to the top, in the top four right now.
Yeah, Shanahan has everything to play for. These do some upset championship. 1.30, pushing Oliver Evans.
Look at the shot of Evans off the sideline. Here we go, Shanahan's coming for blood. Can Evans hold his nerve? Oh, a little contact accidentally, but it's staying going.
And look at this, Shanahan now starts to bring the fire as they come down to the point. So Shanahan's driving it in as they come door to door from 5-5.
Thank you.
side on the point. And they finished off our team time here at the T side.
What a Shanahan got.